best lap so far is a 1:16.4. best lap so far is a 1 minute 16.1.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Vettel, Ricciardo and Lewis Hamilton. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Bad luck in qualifying. That's not exactly ideal. But there's no points for Saturday. Keep a cool head and make up for it in the race.
It's always wonderful to come back to the lively Hungaroring. A popular destination this, nice and close to the beautiful city of Budapest, with some exciting racing to boot. Who can forget Michael Schumacher pushing his old teammate Rubens Barrichello up towards the pit wall in 2010, or those great races of 2014 and 2015 as well. Located 12 miles northeast of the Hungarian capital Budapest, the 14 corners of the Hungaroring are steeped in history and prestige. Overtaking has always been difficult on this technical 2.7-mile circuit, but the last few years in particular have turned up some exceptional races. Let's hope we're in for another one here today. Also here, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Kevin Magnussen. They've had to change their gearbox. It's never a good start to a Grand Prix when, right off the bat, you have to contend with a grid penalty.
Fingers crossed that's one failure they won't have to worry about today, at least. There's not much of a silver lining to starting down the field with a penalty, but I think they'll be able to make some of that back up over the course of the race.
With that, then, let's run through the grid order. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Valtteri Bottas, Power, Hülkenberg, Sainz, Perez, and Fernando Alonso. Ocon, Grosjean.
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. System checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. note, no rain currently expected. Lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. Strong start. Well done. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD. This lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Okay, gap ahead is 2.1 seconds. Fuel is at target plus 3, let's get into mix 3 ASAP. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Okay. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD. let's be patient going into turn one. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race. Good luck. Confirmed. We'll receive you at the end of this lap. ERS deployment. Go, go, go. up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Trailing our teammate by 23.6 seconds. Brilliant. Nice move. Sebastian's in for his stop. Our gap to the car in front is 3.6 seconds. some energy harvesting, reduce ERS deployment. Second a lap faster, 1 second.
So, another fantastic victory for Red Bull today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres. But at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else. And that's exactly what they had today.
And I can see now the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. It's a good result for Sebastian Vettel, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
It's got to be Romain Grosjean. He was in another league.
Bad luck out there today. What do you think went wrong? Not the best way to end a race. What went wrong? It looks like your rival bested you today, doesn't it? Appreciate your time.
You okay? Nothing more than bumps and bruises, I hope. I wish I could say the same for the car. That thing is quite a mess. What a disappointing end to a lot of hard work this weekend. Still, we've got plenty of repair time before the next race. It'll be just like new in time for the next Grand Prix.
Here we can adjust the terms of our proposal. The more ambitiously we set our targets, the more willing the team will be to give us better perks. We'll have a few chances to suggest a deal, but we need to be careful. If a proposed contract exceeds your value to the team, it will be rejected, and too many attempts will leave us stuck with the original offer. From here, we can change the team that we're negotiating with. There's no rule saying you need to stay in the same seat forever. Selecting a team here only affects the negotiation. The actual move won't take place until the following race weekend. Good thinking. Maybe there are better options elsewhere. Thank you. All right, the terms have been agreed. All that's left is to sign the paperwork. You'll be on this new deal from the next race weekend. We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate. I've been in touch with some contacts at Williams, and they think your attitude and results might be a good fit for their team. We can talk to them at our next contract review if you're interested. Let's see what kind of offer they can put on the table.
We've arrived in Belgium for the next installment on the Formula One calendar. It'll come as no surprise to many that it's... We'll be right back. interesting practice session there, then. It's qualifying time at Spa.
Okay, you should be able to get into the next qualifying session easily, so try to get a hot lap in early so we can save the tyres. So far, our fastest lap is a 1. The car settings screen on your multifunction display will allow you to change various settings as you drive. Open the display with the MFD button. You can then navigate up and... We'll be right back. session.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Vettel, Hamilton and Power. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
Obviously, I expected a better session, but these things happen from time to time. Try to make up for it in the race.
In the 48 races held at Spa between 1950 and 2015, the race winner has only started from pole position on 16 occasions. Qualifying yesterday may have set the order for today, but expect the unexpected here at the Belgian Grand Prix. As the saying goes, of course, anything can happen. And you know what? It usually does. So here we are once again at Spa-Francorchamps, with 19 corners, 9 to the right and 10 to the left, and a lap distance of 4.35 miles. An average lap speed in the dry here is around 145 miles per hour. It's a very quick circuit indeed. Anthony Davidson is alongside me in the commentary box to take you through all the action today. Now, it's a closely matched field here in Spa, Ant. So where do you think we're going to see somebody make a difference?
If they're as close as we're expecting them to be, especially through the midfield, then being able to keep the front tyres in good condition could make the difference. You always lose a chunk of downforce at the front when you're in the turbulent air of another car, which tends to cause understeer, which in turn causes front tyre degradation. Now, too much damage there could force an early pit stop and put you at a slight disadvantage, so the drivers will want to be careful not to be too aggressive early on in the Grand Prix.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying.
Okay, remember to brake early for turn one, as the pack's gonna bunch up. There's plenty of runoff if things get too close.
Thank you.
Let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. Rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. Let's overtake. See a bit of tire wear. You shouldn't have too much trouble for the time being, but the grip is going to start falling away. was the fastest lap of the race so far. Behind is 1.6 seconds. Speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Some information on Ericsson. They seem to have an issue. 0 seconds. Sebastian is in the pits. Verstappen is stopping now. We're leading our teammate by 3.8 seconds. discharge is high. Let's increase ERS deployment to up the pace. ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Thank you. Slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. behind us is 4.2 seconds. Yellow flag. Green flag. Of fuel remaining. We're not going to be able to run in this engine mode much. On Ocon, they have some kind of mechanical problem. This set of tyres is pretty much spent, I think. You should be able to bring a bit more out, but it won't be long before they fall away from you entirely. Thank you. laps of fuel remaining. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
Great effort there from Ferrari to take the victory today. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time, though, goodbye.
Great workout there today. How do you think it went? You took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win? Everything went your way today. It looked like you had a really good strategy for the race. You performed better than last weekend. What changed? You're surpassing all expectations. Can anything or anyone stop you? Great. Well, that's everything.
Great work this weekend. It was fantastic to see you up on that podium.
Okay, we had the new parts come through from the factory. We'll get them on the car ahead of FP1.